Hi, this is Maginoni. Here's my review for Block B's second mini-album, Welcome to the Block. I wonder if this is like Jenny from the... or J-Lo from the Block. But, anyways. As you can see, it's a hardcover CD. And there's six songs, but one of the songs is instrumental. I try to translate this. And I think song four says... Maginoni is 100% the best. I think that's what it translates to. I might be a little wrong because I couldn't understand what one that symbol was, but I think that's what it translates to. But anyways, as you can see, this is a hardcover. It's very, very thick, cardboardish type. I don't even want to call it paper. So it's a very unique design, and They definitely spent some money on this. This is the limited edition collector's edition. Now, oh, here's the side. I don't think I showed that to you. Okay, now, I bet you're wondering, all right, Maginoni, you've been talking too much. How does this thing open? And I bet you're thinking, because there's arrows here, it'd be sliding. Well, you know what? You'd be thinking wrong. It does not slide. How does it open, you say? Very simply, it opens like this. And it has the Block B symbol here, Welcome to the Block, there, in case you couldn't figure out what you were buying. And as you can see, it's raised. So this is basically what kind of holds it together. Now, let's take a look at the inside. I don't know if you guys are ready to do it. I can't feel the love that says, I am ready to see Block B. I don't know. Maybe I should redo this another time. Alright, I'll do it. Here it is. Here's the actual CD itself. I actually do like the CD design. The way, you know, the symbols here, then the circles around it. I think that was really a nice creative touch, and it kind of goes well with the overall theme. They denied me. Nothing underneath. But on the plus side, is I do like how it sits inside the CD case itself, you know, inside the cardboard, and there's that, obviously, that slit there that you can stick your finger in and pop it out. Let's take a look at the book. Now, I bet you you're thinking to yourself, God, this book better not be glued to the actual case. Well, guess what? It's not. If you saw the tab, you would have said, Maginoni, I am not falling for your tricks. Here's the booklet. Now, one thing I really did like about this booklet is it told you information about the people. Now, I understand that there's a lot of Block B fanatics out there who know everything about these guys. They know their shoe sizes. They know what their favorite drinks are, their favorite foods. How many hairs they have on their head, and I get that. But imagine somebody who is new to Block B and doesn't really know much about the band and hasn't worshipped them yet. Well, what this book does is it tells you basically here's their name, and it tells you basically what their role is in the band. You know, like, there's the rap leader, you have, and of course, then there's the pitchers, then there's, like, another rap, dance. That's, think about it. How, alright, now understand that it's like, to be in a band like this would be probably an amazing thing to happen to somebody. But you're just known as dance. You know, you don't do anything like I sing. You're just there to sub vocal and dance. This guy doesn't even get to sing. His mic is turned off. But I really do like this, you know, what they did here. I think this is a really, really good thing. And I wish more bands would do stuff like this, because I think, you know, looking at it from a new fan type thing, you get to understand who these people are better. And It's, you know, you don't have to, like, spend hours going to websites going, okay, who's this guy, who's that guy, and this is what their roles are, and trying to match them to videos. Now you can just sit here with the book and go, I know who he is, and that's what he does. So I wish more bands, well, I guess what I'm trying to say is I wish more bands would take the time to, or I shouldn't say not bands, but the management companies would take the time to do stuff like that. It's the little things that I think make it more personal. And I think stuff like that just connects a little bit better with other fan base. Now, obviously there's some bands like Big Bang, maybe you don't necessarily need it on every single book, because I think that would be kind of redundant. But with newer acts, I think it's like a really good thing to do. But anyways, that's my Block B limited edition book, or sorry, not book, but CD. If you have any comments or questions, let me know. I do not know if I'm going to get the regular CD. I have other CDs I would like to buy, so I'm not sure. Maybe if like a billion people go, I need to see it, maybe I will get it. But at least for right now, it's just the limited edition. Anyways, beyond that, if you have any comments or questions, let me know. Rate the video up or down. Let me know what you think. He was quite happy and pleased with the Block B's case. He gives it a thumbs up approval. And I'll have more reviews later. I just got another K-pop CD. And I got sick, so it really pushed me behind. So I'll try to get something out maybe tomorrow or Friday. So until next time.